Good morning. In this class, we will study about transversal and transversal of parallel lines. First, we should understand what is called intersecting lines. When two or more lines have a common point, for example, these are the two lines, and these two lines have a common point. These two lines have a common point here. Then these lines are called intersecting lines. And the point where they are meeting each other is called point of intersection. It's very simple to understand. These lines are intersecting lines. They can meet anywhere. There can be many points also. These lines are called intersecting lines. And the point where they meet each other, these points are called point of intersection. Okay. Then what is called transversal? A line that intersects two or more lines at distinct point is called a transversal. So I'm having two lines here. I'm having another line. So this line is meeting these two lines at these two points. I'm drawing here a line. So this line is meeting these two lines at here and here. So what I can say, if this line is P, this is L, M, and if this line is A, B, C, D, E, F. What can I say? P is transversal. P is transversal to L and M. P is a line that meets the line L and M at two different points. So what I can say, this line is transversal to L and M. Here what I can say, C is transversal. C is transversal to A and B. Here F is transversal to D and E. Okay. So we can give more examples. I'm having not only two lines, I'm having many lines. So this is A and B, C, D and E. So here what I can say, A is transversal to B, C, D and E. Suppose I'm drawing another line here, I can say M, another line here N. Here what I can say, M is transversal to B, C, D, E. N is transversal to B, C, D. Not only like this, here. So similarly, we can say this line B. B is transversal to the line A, M and N. So it's like C is transversal to A, M, N, D and E. These two lines are transversal to A, M, N. Okay. Oh, there is another example. Here also there are number of lines. But all these lines meet at a common point like this. This is not transversal. Because all these lines are meeting at a single point. But to be transversal, a line that intersects two or more lines at distinct points. Okay, then only we can call the line to be a transversal. Next we will study what are the angles made by a transversal. To understand this, I'm drawing two lines. Let me name it as L, M. I'm drawing a line P. Here we know that P is transversal to this line L and M. So what are the angles? And here I can draw an angle. Let I name it as angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, and this is angle 4. Similarly here, I can name angle 5. Angle 6, angle 7, angle 8. Okay, you can name anything, ABCD or anything as you wish, and in any order also. So first we will understand what is interior angles. These are the two lines L and M. What are the angles which is inside this line from here to here? Okay, these are the two lines. Within this line L and M there are four angles. 3, 4, 5 and 6. These four angles are called interior angles. angles which is inside the line between L and M. So I can write angle 3, angle 4, angle 5, angle 6. All these angles are called interior angles. Then similar way, what are exterior angles which is outside the line L and M? So here, from here and from here, outside the line L and M. So here angle 1, angle 2, angle 8, angle 7. The next thing, pair of corresponding angles. So here there are each of them is an interior angle, each of them is an exterior angle. Now we are going to see some pair of corresponding angles. So there should be two angles that together they can be called as corresponding angles. How to figure it out? The same figure, I am drawing it here. Okay. So here is the angle that is in the top left. Similarly, this is the corresponding angle of this. So this is angle 1 and this is angle 5. Similarly here, this side I am drawing angle which is angle 2. The corresponding angle is angle 6. Similarly here, this is angle 4. The corresponding angle is here angle 8. And the last one, this is angle 3. The corresponding angle for that is 7. So here you can see, this is on the top of this line, and this is also on the top of this line, which is on the left side here and it is on the right side here. This is on the bottom side and it is on the bottom side. So this pair are called pair of corresponding angles. So how we can write this? Angle 1 and angle 5, that is one pair. Next is angle 2 and angle 6, that is this pair. Next is angle 4 and angle 8, and the last one is angle 3 and angle 7. There are four pair of corresponding angles. The next is, what is pair of alternate interior angles? So we know that what are interior angles, that we have already know. 3, 4, 5, 6 are interior angles. From that, we have to write what are the pair of interior angles. We draw a line like this. Okay. So angle between these two lines are called interior angles. So then what is called this alternate interior angles? We can form a Z-shaped curve. Not exactly it will look like Z, but okay, if you take this Z shape, this curve and this angle and this angle are alternate interior angles. Similarly, if you go from here, this angle and this angle are alternate interior angles. So this is one pair and this is another pair. What is this? This is 4 and this is 6 and this is 3. And from this figure, I'm writing the numbers. And this is 5. If you want to write it here, pair of alternate interior angles, angle 4 and angle 6. This is one pair. Another pair is angle 3 and angle 5. This is another pair. There are two pair of alternate interior angles. The next is pair of alternate exterior angle. So exterior angle is, we draw like this. So what, first of all, what is exterior? The angle which is outside this line, exterior angle. So this and this is one pair. Similarly, this and this is another pair. Okay, so what is this number? This is 1, this is 7, this is 2 and this is 8. Angle 1 and angle 7, this is one pair. Angle 2 and angle 8, this is another pair. There are two pairs of alternate exterior angles. There is another thing is called pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal. We know that what is interior angle? What is interior angle? The angle which lies inside these two lines are called interior angles. Now, the pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal. This is the transversal. On the same side means these two angles are on the left hand side of the transversal. These two angles are on the right hand side of the transversal. And all these are interior angles. So, this is called, first of all, these four angles are interior angles. Out of that, these two angles lie on the left hand side of the transversal and these are on the right hand side of the transversal. So, these two pairs are called pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Let me write the numbers. This is 4 and 5. This is 3 and 6. So, angle 4 and angle 5 is one pair. Another pair is angle 3 and angle 6. So, this is, now we know what is called interior angle, exterior angle, corresponding angle, pair of alternate interior angle, pair of alternate exterior angle, pair of interior angle on the same side of the transversal. Okay. Name the pair of angles in each figure. So, here you can say this 1 and 2 is called corresponding angles. Okay, they are on the, this is on the left top of the transversal. So, this is 1 and 2 are corresponding angles. You can see here there is a Z-shaped curve like this, which comes like this. So, this and this are called alternate interior angles. So, next you can see these are interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Interior angles on the same side of transversal. This 7 and 8, so this is a transversal, the 7 and 8 are corresponding angles. And here this, you can see the Z shape here. So 9 and 10 are alternate interior angles. So what is this 11 and 12? They are exterior angles, but they together you can call it as a linear pair. Because this angle 11 and angle 12 are adjacent, and if you add the total angle, it will give 180 degree. Because this is a straight line. So, angle 11 plus angle 12 will give 180. So, that it is a 11 and 12 are exterior angles. But what pair together we can call it as linear pair. Next is transversal of parallel lines. So, here you can see I can name it as P. This is L, M. Okay. Here I can say this P is transversal to this line L and M. Here also I can say if A, B and C, A is transversal to B and C. So what is the difference between these two lines L and M and B and C? Here L and M lines, they are not parallel. Here B and C lines are parallel. Here is also I can say P is transversal to L and M, A is transversal to B and C. Okay, this is about transversal. Now, out of these two figures, in here, this L is not parallel to M and B is parallel to C. What is called parallel lines? Lines on a plane that do not meet anywhere. What does it mean? If I extend this L and M, you can see within this area, this L and M do not meet each other. But if I extend L and M, at somewhere they are going to meet each other. So, these line L and line M are not parallel. But if you see the figure here, this line B and C, even if you are extending on both the sides, the line B and C will not meet each other. The distance between the lines, this distance is going to be the same throughout. Okay, so such lines are called parallel lines. So B and C are parallel lines. Here also whatever we have seen, this is going to be the same. There are four angles formed here and also four angles formed here. here also there are four angles formed. Let's name here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Okay, similarly here also four angles form top and four angles are formed at the bottom. The difference between these two is here the lines are not parallel and here the lines B and C are parallel. Now we are going to see some other proof what happen if these lines are both are parallel. The first thing is if two parallel lines are cut by a transversal. Here these are the two lines B and C. These lines are cut by a transversal, that is A. Each pair of corresponding angles are equal in measure. So here what they are saying is the corresponding angles are equal. So now we have to prove how the corresponding angles are equal. Here is also we can name the same thing 1, 2, 3, 4. Here it is 5, 6, 7 and 8. Okay. So now using a protractor I am going to measure the angle 1 and angle 5. So angle 1 and angle 5 are corresponding angles. Here also angle 1 and angle 5 are corresponding angles. Let me write what are the corresponding angles. Angle 1 and angle 5, angle 4 and angle 8, angle 2 and angle 6, angle 3 and angle 7. Okay, since I have named in the same order in both the figures, these are the corresponding angles of both the figures. Now, what is the new thing we are going to learn is, if these two lines are parallel, then these corresponding angles are going to be the same. For example, I am going to measure angle 1 and angle 5 and going to check whether they are same or not. Okay, so keeping your, just you can measure. You can see this is angle 1 from here to here. Angle 1, it is 0. You can see angle 1 is 100 degree. Okay, so I am going to measure what is angle 5 here. You can see here. Angle 5 from here to here is also 100. So what does it mean is, if the two lines are parallel, then the corresponding angles are going to be the same. Here is also, yeah, these two lines are not parallel. From the figure itself, we can say this angle 1 is not equal to angle 5. Okay, similarly, you can measure, you can check with the remaining angles. If you want to measure, this is angle 2. Angle 2 will be equal to angle 6. Okay, so what does the theorem say? Proof says if the two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, each pair of corresponding angles are equal in measure. So from this figure we can write what are the corresponding angles. Now angle 1 is equal to angle 5, angle 4 equal to angle 8, angle 2 equal to angle 6 and angle 3 is equal to angle 7. Next, already we know that what are called vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles are equal. So I am going to write all the vertically opposite angles. Angle 1 equal to angle 3. Angle 2 equal to angle 4. Angle 6 equal to angle 8. Angle 5 equal to angle 7. These are vertically opposite angles and these angles are equal. Okay. Now from these two lines what you can say, I am writing this angle 1 equal to angle 5 and here angle 1 equal to angle 3. And from here angle 4 equal to angle 8 and here is angle 4 equal to angle 2. From these two things what you can say, this is angle 1 and this is angle 1, left hand side are equal, so this right hand side should be equal, which says angle 5 equal to angle 3, and from this you can say angle 8 equal to angle 2. Now I am going, similarly you can say angle 2 equal to angle 6. Here you can say angle 2 equal to angle 4. Angle 2 equal to angle 4. So from this you can say angle 6 equal to angle 4. Okay. And from here angle 1 equal to angle 3, angle 3 equal to angle 7. From these two I can say angle 1 equal to angle 7. So we have these two, angle 5 equal to angle 3, angle 6 equal to angle 4. Now, seeing the figure, what is angle 5 equal to angle 3? This is angle 5 equal to angle 3. These two angles, this angle and this angle are equal. And angle 6 equal to angle 4. This angle and this angle are equal. So in the Z shape, this angle and this angle are equal. These two angles are equal. Similarly, angle 8 equal to angle 2. Angle 1 equal to angle 7. So this is angle 1. This angle 1 is equal to angle 7. This angle 2 equal to angle 8. So in summary, I can say if two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, each pair of alternate interior angles are equal. Which means if I consider these two lines are parallel, then this angle and this angle are going to be same. And also this angle and this angle are going to be same. These angles are called alternate interior angles. Okay, these angles are same only if these two lines are in parallel. If these two lines are not parallel, they are then also they are alternate interior angles, but they are not equal. Okay. The next is the same figure. You can see this is a straight line. Okay, this is a straight line. We know that angle 1 plus angle 4. This is angle 1 and this is angle 4. If you add it together, this is a straight line. So angle 1 plus angle 4 together will give 180. Okay. Now we know that angle 1 equal to angle 5. Angle 1 is equal to angle 5. Why? Because this angle 1 and angle 5 are corresponding angles and these two lines are parallel. So they must be equal. They are corresponding angles. And if I say is L and M, I have to say L is parallel to M. Okay. So this angle 1 is equal to angle 5. Now, instead of this angle 1, I can write angle 5 because they are both are equal. So, angle 5 plus angle 4 equal to 180. So, this angle, angle 5, if you add these two angles, they should give 180. I am not saying these two angles 4 and 5 are equal. I am saying when I add these two angles, it should give 180. What is this angle 4 and angle 5? Angle 4 and angle 5 are interior angles. They are not only interior angles and they lie on the same side of the transversal. They lie on the left hand side of the transversal. Similarly, I can say angle 3 and angle 6. Angle 3 plus angle 6 is 180. Okay. So, if two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, then each pair of interior angles. So, of this figure, 3, 4, 5, 6 are interior angles. Out of this four angles, each pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary. What is supplementary? When you add two angles, they should sum up to give 180. So when you add 4 and 5, it is giving 180. When you add 3 and 6, it is giving 180. Okay. To sum up all the things we have studied, I have drawn this figure. First we will write which pairs of corresponding angles are equal. Okay. First I am writing corresponding angles. So angle 1 is equal to angle 5. Angle 2 equal to angle 6. Angle 3 equal to angle 7. Angle 4 equal to angle 8. All these are corresponding angles that are equal because these two lines are in parallel. All this will happen only when this L is parallel to M. Okay. Next is what happened to alternate angles. First we will see alternate interior angles. So this is Z here. So angle 3 equal to angle 5. These two angles are equal and these two angles are equal. Angle 4 equal to angle 6. These are alternate interior angles. And what happened to alternate exterior angle? Angle 1 equal to angle 7. Angle 2 equal to angle 8. The next is, what happened to the interior angles that is on the same side of the transversal. So if you add angle 4 plus angle 4 plus angle 5, angle 4 plus angle 5, it will give 180 degree. If you add angle 3 plus angle 6, add these two, that will give 180 degree. These are the three important thing you should know. Now, so far we have learned so many properties. Using those properties, now we have to find this. Here they have given L is parallel to M. Okay, so L is parallel to M. Then what will be the value of X is 60. Because alternate interior angle. These two are alternate interior angles. In case if L is parallel, they should be equal. And here what is Y is 55. The same thing, alternate interior angle. The next thing, here is also, it is like this. They have asked the question, is angle 1 equal to angle 2? You can see a Z here, okay? But this angle 1 is not equal to angle 2. No, why is the reason? Because L is not parallel to M. You can see here, if these two lines are parallel like this, then you can say this angle 1 equal to angle 2. Okay, here L is in this direction and M is in this direction. They are going to meet somewhere. These two lines are not parallel. So, angle 1 is not equal to angle 2. Okay, here they have given L is parallel to M. They have given these two lines are parallel and they have asked what is Z. So, these are interior angles that lies on the same side of the transversal. This is a transversal line. So, 60 plus Z together is 180. Okay, if you add that interior angles on the same side of the transversal, that should give 180. So, Z is 180 minus 60. So, Z is 120 degree. Now, here, they have given L is parallel to M. These two are parallel. Then what is X? X is 120 because corresponding angles, because this angle and this angle are corresponding angles, if these lines are parallel, they are equal. Now here we are, they have said L is parallel to M and P is parallel to Q. Okay. Now, this angle is 60. When this angle is 60, these two angles are interior angles that lie on the same side of the transversal. So, A plus 60 is 180. So, A is 120. So, this angle I can say this is 120 degree. Okay. Now, I have to find all these angles B, C and D. Okay. Now, what is this angle? First, I will start with this angle. What is this angle? This angle and this angle are corresponding angles. So, here is a line and here is a line and here is a line. I am drawing this line alone. That is the Q line. This is L line and this is M line. This line is A, which is 120. Okay. So, this and this are corresponding angles. They should be equal. So, this angle is 120. 120 degree. When this is 120 degree, what about D? D is 120 because they are vertically opposite. They are vertically opposite angle. So, I can say D is 120. Now, this is a straight line. Okay, this is a straight line. When you add B and D together, B plus D and together, you will get 180. We know what is D, what is B is 180 minus D. That is 180 minus 120, that is equal to 60. So, B is 60. If B is 60, what is C? B and C are vertically opposite. C is also 60 because B and C are vertically opposite angles. Now, we are going to read these two statements. If two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, each pair of corresponding angles are equal in measure. So we know this statement. There are two parallel lines. I am saying L is parallel to M. This is L and this is M. Okay, these two lines are parallel and these two parallel lines are cut by a transversal. This is a transversal line, P line. Then I will say the corresponding angles are equal. Let me write only one angle. Let it be 1 and let it be 2. These two are corresponding angles. Angle 1 is angle 2. This we have already proved. Now, the same thing what I said here is, when a transversal cut two lines, this from here to here, they didn't say anything about parallel. When a transversal cut two lines, there are simply two lines, okay? And a transversal is going to cut these two lines. I'm drawing a transversal which is cutting these two lines such that the pair of corresponding angles are equal. The transversal is cutting two lines such that the corresponding angles are equal, which means in this case, I am taking this side, this angle is equal to this angle. Let me take this 1, 2. Angle 1 equal to angle 2. This is the condition given here. Then the lines have to be in parallel. So if angle 1 and angle 2 are equal, then these two lines are parallel. In short, we can say what is the difference between these two statements is, here is saying if L is parallel to M. If L is parallel to M, then angle 1 equal to angle 2. This is what the first statement says. What is the second statement says? Here, if angle 1 equal to angle 2, if this angle 1 equal to angle 2, then if I name it as A and if I name it as B, name it as C, and A is parallel to B. These two lines should be in parallel. Okay? So, from this, what question I can ask is, I am having two lines and these two lines are in parallel. I am giving that these two lines are parallel and I am asking whether this one is equal to two. The answer is yes, because they are corresponding angles. From this figure, I am not saying these two lines are parallel. I am saying there are some line, two lines, and a transversal is cut the line at here and here. I'm giving the condition angle 1 equal to angle 2. The corresponding angles are equal. If the corresponding angles are equal, this is possible only if angle A is parallel to angle B. Okay. So here they are saying this is parallel, then corresponding angles are equal. If the corresponding angles are equal, then that two lines is going to be parallel. Similarly, you can say for remaining things also. If I'm saying... A transversal is cut the two lines here, and I'm saying here this is angle A, I'm saying this is angle B. Okay, let me take this L and M. If angle A equal to angle B, which means they are alternate interior angles, okay? Then also L is parallel to M. Similarly, I'm saying if, suppose it is angle C and angle D. Angle C equal to angle D, then also L is parallel to M. Okay, because they are alternate interior angles. Similarly, I am giving another condition. I am giving a condition like, this is angle F and this is angle H. Okay, I am saying angle F plus angle H is 180. If I am adding these two angles, I am getting 180. My question is L is parallel to M. Okay, now the answer is yes. Because this is a transversal. Okay, these are interior angles. If you add the interior angles on the same side of the transversal, if it is supplementary, if it gets 180, then these two lines are parallel. So, is L is parallel to M? Yes, L is parallel to M. Similarly, these two angles, if you add up, that also will give 180. Now, here, they asked a question, is L is parallel to M? We have to say whether these two lines are parallel or not. You should not say just by seeing the figure. They have given this angle and this angle are equal. They are alternate angles, alternate interior angles. If the alternate interior angles are equal, then these are parallel. The reason is yes. Why? Alternate interior angles are equal. So, L is parallel to M. The question is again the same. They have asked if this L is parallel to M. This angle is 50. Okay. Now, what we can do is, this angle is 130. Okay, this angle and this angle are vertically opposite angles. Okay, even though if L and M are parallel or not parallel, always the vertical opposite angles are equal. So, this angle is 130. Now, we can see, if you add these two angles, which is 130 plus 50, you will get 180. Okay, so what you can say? Interior angles on the same side of transversal. It's a pair of interior angles. Okay, this pair, this is one pair and this is one pair. This side is one pair. These two angles is one pair and these two angles is one pair. So, I'm saying this pair of interior angle on the same side of the transversal are supplementary. What is supplementary? If you are adding these two angles, if it gives 180, then you can call it as supplementary. If this condition is satisfied, then these two lines are parallel. So, yes, these two lines are parallel. The next question is, they have given if L is M. They told that these two lines are parallel. Then what is X? So, what is X? This is 70, then this is X. So, if I add X plus 70, it should give 180 because they are interior angle that lies on the same side of the transversal. So, 80, 180, that is 110. So, X is 110. Okay. So, by this we have completed some introduction to exercise 5.2. From next class we start with exercise 5.2. Thank you.